I am coming up from the beach, and I tried to get some shots down there, and they weren't very good. They don't want me down there at all. The Hurricane Hanna has flooded out the sides of the road, and I think some fencing might have gotten compromised, and parking is at a minimum because it's flooded out. The isthmus was opened, except there was some slight water on the eastbound lane. There's a lot of standing water in the launch site area. And road closure is still on. The road underneath me here is all flooded out. This is 2 days after the eye of the storm. before the storm, this was all staged with stores and receiving, and I had some mobile units here. And after the storm, it's all pretty much cleared away, and we have a clear view into the bunker building right here. Activity for tests, so I'm just wondering if there still is a test, but I've had my phone pretty quiet, nobody's said anything. There's a lot of securing going around, a lot of security walking back and forth. They got the fence down. Welders are showing up. I'm not sure what's going on. A lot of the trucks are having trouble parking outside of water, so they're kind of bunched up into an area that they don't usually park in. There's been a lot of people transported into the area, plus the workers on the bunker build, plus the people that are meeting up on the hillside, on the test site. And it's really busy. Well, the Rocket Restaurant is still intact. I don't know what it's called, I just said that. I don't know why it came out. Elon can give me a message, or if anybody knows. But the Hurricane Hanna was not phasing this too much. It just looks the same as I saw it before Hurricane Hanna. Actually, it looks really better. I've got the plant life in, the trees. That guy go. There's a guy putting some paint on the awnings. And the observation stand slash bandstand slash mingling area, I'm not sure what it's all going to be called, but it did have fencing slats, wooden slats, and they planked it with this, I don't know if it's spruce or what they planked it with, but it's really nice wood, and it's treated. And they've taken all the extra dirt mounds out and put the plant life in. And this is right at the corner when you come out here on LBJ and Highway 4. And hopefully it'll have rocket burgers and rocket hot dogs and a rocket roastery. And I don't know anymore. I don't know anything, actually. Okay, we are on Esperson, going out towards LBJ Boulevard, and it doesn't look too bad from the storm. To the right of us is like a lake of water over by the solar farm, and a lot of limbs down. And I'm looking at some stores that are stacked around, and it's not too bad. They turned things like the picnic tables upside down, and they did some draping on some stores. And I'm not seeing much damage. Just a lot of water, just a lot of standing water. It is very, very humid. It's gonna rain in the forecast. It's supposed to rain. And it's about 90 degrees. And it looks like Elon maybe staying somewhere else. Quite a few Teslas. A lot of Bambis at these first two homes here, so that's high security area. Well, right here at San Martin, you can kind of tell by the new saplings that were planted. Don't have a good root system yet. And with all the water from the hurricane storm, you can tell the direction that they got hit by, the way they're leaning. And some trees didn't make it at all. They got hit flat on. Just not enough time to get enough roots going. Yeah, I want to drive by and see the mud pit behind our old villa. It was the lowest point, and ducks would even land in the backyard because there would be so much water. And that's why we did not fill like SpaceX did. We were advised not to fill the front yard and bring it up because we needed that absorption to keep the backyard from flooding. But the garden box that I planted in, that I built in front of the villa, was used as a breakwater because the water would come down so fast in torrent rains. And it would also, you can see right there between the shop and the villa, that breezeway would be like a muddy river running through between the two. And that garden box helped divert it from hitting the stucco house. And then you'd just have to scoop out the breezeway. But I imagine with them bringing up the elevation in the front yard now, the water just poured into the shop yesterday with those heavy rains. Yeah. Yep, it's a mud pond back there. It's pretty muddy. Well, that's the view from San Martin here behind the villa, and there just isn't a lot of storm damage, just some flooding. That's normal. That's always typical for this neck of the woods to have, you know, mud pits and piled up water waiting to perk. And we'll go back through the village and see what's happening with Rocket Restaurant on the way out. And the Bambis are being staged mostly at the other end on the left-hand side. I'm not sure why that... get my tires cleaned off here. Go through these mud puddles and clean off my tires. The trick I've always done. CAHS, Central Air and Heating Services. my carrier. And it's a local telephone number. The grotto is undamaged. Everything looks pretty intact there. Boy, this is the busy street. And they're trying to get the drains to pump out. A lot of water in this field to the right here. But the solar farm looks great. Don't even see anybody out there squaring anything away. These trees here are leaning, these saplings here on the face. Some of them are down, but that's to be expected with that young of a planting. The driver was having some fun and toying with him the minute he reached down to put the pad under the stabilizer. he did it again. This time for reals.
So they're gonna pick this box off of this fifth wheel, and didn't work. I heard an aw shit, so maybe they gotta move him over to the north a little further. Could be a rock. The driver was having some fun and toying with him the minute he reached down to put the pad under the stabilizer. He did it again. This time for reals. So they're gonna pick this box off of this fifth wheel, and that didn't work. I heard an aw shit, so maybe they gotta move him over to the north a little further. A rock. Tires are off the ground now, booming up. This is the old village water tank for the Copernic Shores village, and the hotel, swimming pool. I even think there was a pipe for the restaurant that was down on the end of the pier there at half a mile north on Boca Chica Beach. Now the reason that the water tank is humongous and it's intact. It's been inspected. It's still usable. The reason they don't use it is because there was a huge hurricane in 1967, and it was Hurricane Beulah. And the foot of the intake pipe was in the Rio Grande River and buried across this field and down the dry bay and into the Rio Grande. So when Beulah tore out the intake foot, the intake valve in the river, when it swelled up and had all the trees coming down it, it wiped out the intake valve. The villagers went to replace it and Cameron County stopped them and said, "Nope, you don't get water." And that was their way of drying up a beautiful dream come true, a beautiful forever home for some of these people that had invested heavily. I think the developer of Copernic Shores, I've heard twice that he committed suicide. He was so heavily invested. Some families stuck it out. The ones, the old timers that you saw, second and third generation, there's Cheryl Girl, Boca Chica Girl, that's Cheryl. She was third generation Boca Chican. And Shirley Conrad was second generation. And anyway, the way to get rid of people is to take away their water. And I guess there's not an end to that story. There's another part of that story, but it's not very nice. And that was, there was some heavy land developers just on the other side of the ship canal that wanted the tourist traffic that Boca Chica Beach had before Beulah. And they wanted to develop it and build a causeway and or have the ferry, the causeway finished so that you didn't have to ferry across from the old causeway. Anyway, there was big money involved in that decision and deep pockets, as always. That's the reason for getting rid of Copernic Shores. He just didn't have the right political connections, and the people on South Padre Island did. And I've even talked to people who were in that generation and told me that story firsthand. And I'm not going to repeat names because some are still alive and some are still rich from it. So that's the old water tank. And this is where it's at. It's right where I was standing filming that Grover. And you can see off to the left here, the containers that came from the launch pad before the hurricane. They tidied up the launch pad, not really knowing what a category hurricane that was going to end up. But it's very clean looking down there at the launch pad, as you saw this morning. And this is where they stashed everything. Believe me, it's 110 degrees back there. I'm standing under an umbrella in this equatorial humid heat.